ago, a fiery explosion at a Delaware refinery killed one man and injured eight others. Now, the Motiva company faces more than $70 million in government fines. Tonight, you'll see for the first time some of the company's internal safety documents. Jennifer Frederick is here with the story. Jen?
Dave, the documents come from a safety committee meeting that was held just days before the explosion. The company's own documents reveal the bosses knew parts of the tank farm, including that tank that exploded, were dangerous. That's why the lawyer representing one victim's family says it was all a killer accident waiting to happen. This is what it looked like, a massive tank flattened. A Motiva refinery tank that was supposed to hold sulfuric acid exploded and caved in, killing Jeffrey Davis and injuring eight others. Davis didn't even work for Motiva. He was here as a contractor welding catwalks. He had no idea that the nearby tank was 5 years overdue for inspection.
The death of Jeffrey Davis was directly related to the leaky, corroded, fume-emitting tanks, which were defects that were long-standing, which were known about, and which were never corrected by Motiva.
There's more. Look at this safety notice that was posted on the tank. It reads, "The tank farm needs attention now." Another says a leak was reported. This is just days before the explosion. Government lawyers plan to use these documents to sue Motiva, which could face $70 million in fines. That might sound like a lot of money, but this is just the latest in a long history of plant violations and punishments. Jeffrey Davis's family believes, and the government agrees, the company ignored the rules for one reason: greed.
They were less concerned about safety than they were about production and the bottom line, profits.
The federal government, the state of Delaware, and the dead man's family have all filed suit against Motiva. The family's lawyer believes they might even get more than the $70 million the company could face in government fines. Jennifer Frederick, Fox News.